edsvideo.com. Thank you.
Hello everyone, Dr. Carlo Oyer, emergency physician, here with a follow-up video to the previously posted video about the patient presenting with sore throat and very significant tonsillar exudates, tonsillar swelling, and so on. Let's talk about pharyngitis. Pharyngitis, and a lot of people use tonsillitis kind of equally, but in reality, pharyngitis refers to pharyngeal swelling, while tonsillitis refers to tonsillar swelling and infection. The tonsils are right about here in the area on the red on the right side of this picture, while the pharynx is really the whole thing. Pharyngitis is diagnosed 11 million times in United States urgent care settings. That involves emergency departments and urgent care centers and stuff like that. But the vast majority of them are viral and do not require antibiotics. Actually, pharyngitis is a self-limited disease that goes away in a couple days anyway. So why even worry about this? Well, let's talk about it a little bit. Even though the vast majority of viral and the viruses that cause them are adenovirus, which is typically the most common of all the viral causes, for example, adenovirus can cause lymph node inflammation also, throat swelling and red pharynx, also Orthomyxoviridae, a type of influenza virus, the Epstein-Barr virus, which is infectious mononucleosis, another common virus to cause really thick exudative tonsillitis, a lot of tender lymphadenopathy, especially in the back of the neck, but also herpes simplex virus, measles, and the common cold, which includes rhinovirus, coronavirus, respiratory syncytial virus, parainfluenza, and so on. Of the bacterial causes of pharyngitis, group A beta-hemolytic streptococcus, or GABHS, accounts for 15 to 30% of the cases of acute pharyngitis in children, but 5 to 20% of those in adults. So only the minor proportion, 20%, maybe 30% in kids, are actually strep. Late winter and early spring are the peak of GABHS. The infection is transmitted by respiratory secretions and the incubation is 1 to 3 days after exposure to the virus. To the bacteria that causes the infection. I just got done saying most of them viral and I had virus in my mind. How to make the diagnosis? Well, in patients with acute febrile respiratory illness, physicians accurately differentiate bacterial from viral infections using only history and physical findings about 50% of the time. Actually, they did it this kind of cool study in which they took patients who we knew had strep and patients who we knew had viral pharyngitis, and they had doctors write, okay, they think it's viral, they think it's strep, on a table, and they got it right 50% of the time. So we can't really rely on the history and the exam alone. There has to be more to it than that. So these criteria here help us make a better diagnosis: the absence of a cough, anterior cervical lymph nodes that are swollen and enlarged right here in the throat, a headache, body aches. You have red spots in the palates of the throat, pharyngeal exudates, streptococcal exposure in the past 2 weeks, obviously a high predictor for streptococcal infection, temperature more than 100.9 degrees, tonsillar exudates, and tonsil or pharyngeal exudates. Palatal petechia and scarlatiniform rash, which is a palpable sandpaper-like rash, are highly specific but very uncommon presentation of strep throat. There is a clinical decision rule called CENTAR criteria for the management of sore throat, and if you use this, then you can obviate the need for tests and just treat the patient. How do we do it? Well, we have a patient with a sore throat. Absence on a cough gets a point. Swollen tender anterior cervical nodes gets another point. Presence of a fever, 100.4 degrees Fahrenheit, gets another point. Tonsillar exudates or swelling gets another point. And depending on the age, they get plus 1 or minus 1 for the score. Any score of 0 means it's viral pharyngitis. Don't test, don't give antibiotics, they'll get better. A score of 1, they recommend that you shouldn't do anything, just let it go, but if you really want to, go ahead and do a strep screen or culture. Now, a score of 2 or 3 are those that are also indeterminate, and you should do the strep screen or culture to differentiate viral from bacterial. But if the score is 4, then you don't have to test. Just go ahead and treat the patient with antibiotics. With correct sampling and palatal techniques, a single swab throat culture is 90 to 95% sensitive. But that means that it misses 5 to 10% of all streptococcal infections. This means that if we miss the diagnosis 5 10% of the cases, a negative swab needs to get a culture. But these results are not going to be back for 48 hours. Now, is that wrong? Is that right? Well, we're still going to treat the patient. Most of the reason that we treat streptococcal infection with antibiotics to prevent the complications of pharyngitis and strep, not so much for symptom relief, because patients only get better a certain percent of the patients, and by only by 16 hours of shortened illness duration. So the real reason to treat with antibiotics is to prevent complications, and within 48 hours, we still would accomplish that. Let's talk about the treatment. GABH pharyngitis is self-limited and resolves in a few days, even without treatment. Arguments for antibiotic treatment include acute symptom relief, or feeling better sooner, prevention of supurative and non-supurative complications, and reduce communicability. In other words, other people getting sick from the infection as well, especially in kids who are in school and stuff. What are the complications? This includes bacteremia, or that the bacteria goes into the bloodstream, making the person very sick. Cervical lymphadenitis, endocarditis, which is an infection of the heart and the valves, mastoiditis, which is an infection of the mastoid bone, meningitis, which is inflammation of the meninges, a very serious infection, otitis media, peritonsillar or retropharyngeal abscess, which is a big collection of pus in the neck area beneath the pharynx. Pneumonia can be a complication because of all that infection going down. You can aspirate and get pneumonia. And the non-supportive complications, which includes post-streptococcal glomerulonephritis and rheumatic fever, which is now very rare, and mostly rare because in the United States, we always give antibiotics, so we've done a good thing by decreasing the range of rheumatic fever, but at the same time, added a lot of resistance to the bug. So how to treat streptococcal pharyngitis? Well, penicillin still works. Penicillin V costs $0 at Publix if you're here in Georgia or in Florida, but also amoxicillin or a single shot of penicillin G. Now, if you're allergic to penicillin, you should use erythromycin, Duracef, or Keflex. Now, the following medications are also FDA approved for the treatment of streptococcal pharyngitis, but are not, I'm going to repeat that, but are not recommended by guidelines for primary streptococcal infection. It includes Thithromax, which you use a lot. Actually, most people and most physicians do not know this, but if you are going to treat streptococcal pharyngitis with Thithromax, instead of using the regular pack, which is 2 pills the first day, then 1 pill every day since, till 5 days, you have to use 2 pills every day for the whole 5 days. Also, Biaxin or clarithromycin, Cefsil, Cedax, Omnicef, they're just not the right antibiotic, not the first selection antibiotics. But if you have many allergies, then we have to use what we need to use, of course. What about chronic pharyngeal carriage? A lot of people, you know, a patient presents with strep throat, they do the cultures, they treat the patient, and then they do a culture to follow up, and they still have it, but they have no symptoms. This is called a chronic pharyngeal carriage state, and it's persistent presence of pharyngeal GABHS without active infection or immune inflammatory response. Actually, if you took 100 person in the shopping center and tested all 100, up to 5 of them will show up positive for strep. That is how the infection starts. So they don't get the disease, but they can transmit the disease. And patients may actually carry GABHS in their throats for 1 year despite treatment. So just because you're strep positive on a screen doesn't mean you have to go ahead and treat the patient, only if they're symptomatic. And that's it for my presentation on streptococcal pharyngitis, which was the final diagnosis in this patient. He had a strep screen that was positive. We elected to treat the patient with regular penicillin. And also, we gave her a single dose of steroids, which will decrease the symptom duration and make her feel better sooner. Hope you enjoyed and learned a lot. Bye-bye.
EDSVideo.com. Thank you.